This is Steve Von Till of Neurosis, and you're listening to Tomorrow's Dream on KABF 88.3 FM, community radio in Little Rock, Arkansas, the voice of the people.
Yeah. Ancestry's falling.
That was the Delirium Effect with DOA. A new lyric video they dropped. This is Tomorrow's Dream on KABF. I'm your host, Baker. I see big old block there. Before that, we did some Wizard Hat with Nobody Left. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Lucid Archetype before that, Kilroy Jenkins. And Omnibane with HSDP. Before that was Smoke Signals with The Thing. And we opened the show up. What did we open the show up with? Before We Burn. Smoke Signals. Before We Burn. Fayetteville Band with, that was new to me. I stumbled across them on Bandcamp. And they just released that last month, I believe. Before We Burn from Fayetteville. The song wasn't meant to be. I'm clearly stalling because I thought I had something lined up and it fell apart. Trying to find this post now so I can see where this album is. So I can't find it now. So I'm scrolling through Facebook while we talk. How's that? How are you guys doing? It's Monday. It's, was it next week? I believe is Memorial Day. Hope everybody will enjoy the day off. Stay home. I will be here rocking you out. Okay, I can't find this at all. I'm gonna have to, jump to something else right quick. Let's see what we got lined up. How about, Jesus, that's loud. Some of this is black. Maybe here, if we can get that rolling. While I get things back in order. That's good. We'll go ahead and let this play. Short songs. Fun stuff. I'll figure out what's up next. Jesus. I'll figure out why my cord keeps doing that. The Smoke Signals. They were supposed to be playing a show this weekend. That's one of the many, many that got postponed. I saw that this morning, so I'll do them on, and I'm gonna see if I can get the other bands they were gonna be playing with, a handful of locals, and play them as well. I know you guys can't wait to get out there and go to shows again.
Something is looming over this city.
Stream, voice of the people.
The city that will soon be laid waste by war. Now it is still alive, biding its time. Nobody has yet begun to suspect the impending doom.
That was a big old chunk of Sun Descends Black. The interlude intro thing when I was still talking was Prelude to Extinction / Apocalyptic Design. And we also did from them Desolate Earth, Turning Point, and that last one was Beginning of the End. And I think I got something loaded up. We'll see how this goes. I got some Tire Fire right here on KBF, Tomorrow's Dream. Voice. We'll be right back.
wonder. In case you fucking wonder. Reflections breaking shards of glass. Enslaved by your own vanity. Narcissist suicide.
Let conscience bring us instinct.
Let light bring us light. Let death bring us light.
Inception of my ending.
Let light bring us light. Let death bring us light.
Tune in this coming Tuesday morning at 9:30 a.m. to Community Voices on KABF 88.3 FM for a special program about problems senior citizens are facing in an apartment complex in East Little Rock. You will hear from current and former residents as well as relatives of the residents. That's Tuesday, May 19th, 9 a.m. on 88.3 FM, KABF, the voice of the people.
We are 100,000 watts of community radio here in Central Arkansas. This is KABF 88.3 Little Rock, the voice of the people.
Exploring science in the sea. A fish known as the halfbeak looks like it's about ready to do some knitting, have a sword fight, or give somebody an injection. That's because its lower jaw resembles a needle. It's long, thin, and pointed. But the halfbeak doesn't appear to use it to jab anything at all. There are about 70 species of halfbeaks. They're found in the open ocean or in coastal waters around the world. Most are no more than a few inches long, with sleek, silvery bodies. They live near the surface, so they're darker on top than the bottom, a bit of camouflage from both predators and prey. Their most prominent feature is the lower jaw. It can account for about a quarter of the halfbeak's length, and it usually has a red or orange tip. Halfbeaks don't seem to use the jaw as a weapon, though, and the jaw is fixed in position. It doesn't swing open like the short upper jaw does. Studies have suggested that it's lined with sensors to help the fish detect prey. Not surprisingly, halfbeaks are related to needlefish, which have sharp lower and upper jaws, and they're also related to flying fish. In fact, some species of halfbeaks can fly on their own. They don't travel as far as flying fish, and they're not as graceful, but they can extend the fins on the sides of their bodies to act like wings. And they twist their back ends so the fins on the top and bottom of the body are parallel to the surface. That provides stability, like the tail of an airplane, helping the halfbeak glide above the water. Science in the Sea is a production of the University of Texas Marine Science Institute and is available as a weekly podcast at scienceinthesea.org. I'm Holly Brawley. Today.
right, all right. That was Terminus from Fayetteville with their song Papillon. Good stuff, good stuff. I think we're gonna say that wraps up the local portion of our show for the day. If everything works anyway, you know that never happens, but we'll see. We're gonna do some non-local stuff for the rest of the show. So if you're watching on YouTube now, this is probably about where your transmission ends. We'll see though. Sometimes they let us keep the stuff up. This one, yeah, please work. The Inner Arma is releasing a whole covers album called Garber's Days Revisited. It's the James Bond they used to have, I guess. It was Garber's. So, a bunch of good stuff looks like coming up on that. Here is one they just ripped right out there with Southern Man. Neil Young cover. So here's that Inner Arma, KBF, Tomorrow's Dream, Voice of the People.
Come at last. Now.
again, that was... Oh, Christ. Ads, man. Ads everywhere. They will get you. That was Under Armour covering Neil Young, Southern Maine. I'm wondering what my buddy Robert thinks of that. We just met a couple weeks ago up here at the station. He was telling me he likes all this heavy stuff we play. Just, not so much when the vocals get so harsh they don't actually make notes anymore. You gotta admit though, Neil was all over the place with that song anyway. They got a whole album covers coming up. Check it out. Garber Days Revisited. This is really old Vesperian Sorrow. 2001, I believe. Buddies from Texas. Song is called Solitude. KBF Tomorrow's Dream. Voice of the People.
We'll be right back. Dark. I am the one that's in the mouth of your eye of shot. With the pinch of bars as I pull this blade across my flesh. This is how I live with myself. Every day until my death. A beat of all evil's disease. I will teach you the language of the nation. Convert you from your heart of pain. Feel the lash of the blood of the sun. The life consumed in silent sorrow. Every perception brought from lack of trust. We're saloon, we zoom down, I lose myself in hopeless loss. My side blurs, and I press this gun against my head. My body goes numb, forgetting all the words he said. A beat of all evil's disease. From a lack and destroyer of me. They have become one with the fallen. They are mine from this day forth. I will teach you the language of the nation. Convert you from your heart of pain. Feel the lash of the blood of the sun. The life consumed in silent sorrow.
Double shot. Carnivora from Boston. Good friends of ours that came down there and played a couple times back before the plague. That was Pessimist Tongue from them. Let's, speaking of the plague, see if I can squeeze in a double shot of the last year's Cattle Decapitation album. They freaking called it with this one. Let's do, like I said, a double shot from them, and then we'll get out of here. We'll see you guys next week. Stick around. Vinny's up next with the Boom Hour. This is Cattle Decap with Bring Back the Plague, and then we'll do the title track off of their most recent album, Death Atlas. KBF, Tomorrow's Dream, Voice of the People.
The pictures online of people who seem to think they're invincible. Well, you're not. Enough is enough. Go home and stay home. We'll be right back.
is KABF in Little Rock, 88.3, the voice of the people in Central Arkansas.
Was the first Thanksgiving feast in 1621, 1608, 1598, or 1565? I'll tell you today on Hightower's Radio Lowdown. It's time to talk turkey. No, not the butterball sitting in the Oval Office. I'm talking about the real thing, the big bird, 46 million of which we Americans will devour on this Thanksgiving Day. It was the Aztecs who first domesticated the gallo pavo, but leave it to the Spanish explorers to foul up the bird's origins. They declared it to be related to the peacock. Wrong. They also thought the peacock originated in Turkey. Wrong. And they thought turkey was located in Africa. Well, you can see the Spanish were pretty confused. Actually, the origin of Thanksgiving is confused. The popular assumption is that it was first celebrated by the Mayflower immigrants and the Wampanoag natives at Plymouth, Massachusetts, 1621. They feasted on venison, furkies, Wampanoag for gobblers, eels, mussels, corn, and beer. But wait, say Virginians, the first precursor to our annual November Foodapalooza was not in Massachusetts. The Thanksgiving feast originated down here in Jamestown Colony back in 1608. Whoa there, hold your horses, pilgrims. Folks in El Paso, Texas, say it all began way out there in 1598, when Spanish settlers sat down with the people of the Piro and Manso tribes, gave thanks, then feasted on roasted duck, geese, and fish. Ha, says a Florida group, asserting that the very, very first Thanksgiving happened in 1565, when the Spanish settlers of San Augustine and friends from the Timucuan tribe chowed down on cocido, a stew of salt pork, garbanzo beans, and garlic, washing it all down with red wine. This is Jim Hightower saying, wherever it began and whatever the purist claim is official, Thanksgiving today is as multicultural as America. So let's enjoy. Kick back, give thanks we're in a country with such ethnic richness, and dive into your turkey rellenos, mushu turkey, turkey falafel, barbecue.
What do the corporate powers from Wall Street to Walmart have in common? They hate the Hightower Lowdown. You can see why at www.hightowerlowdown.org.